In terrestrial environments, tropical species experience relatively static temperature and greater biodiversity compared to those at the poles. As a result, they have greater stability across seasons. MacArthur's latitude-niche breath hypothesis has become one of the universally accepted explanations for the trend that species diversity increases from the poles to the equator. MacArthur's hypothesis states that due to greater stability across seasons, species at the tropics experience smaller niches than those at the poles, where niches defined as the habitat and diet of the organism. Consequently, a larger diversity of species are able to coexist in the same niche area at the equator compared to the poles, which leads to greater species richness at the equator than the poles. However, few studies have been conducted that actually test MacArthur's hypothesis, and even fewer studies have been conducted to see if it holds true in the marine environment. Marine environments differ greatly from terrestrial environments in many ways. For instance, at the poles, marine environments experience relatively stable temperature across seasons, whereas terrestrial environments at the poles experience great temperature fluctuations throughout the year. As a result, it should not be surprising that marine studies have indicated that instead of inhabiting large niches, as predicted based on MacArthur's hypothesis, species in the marine environment at the poles actually experience much smaller niches than their counterparts at the equator. The significance of determining niche size and niche overlap of large predator species such as sharks is that in order to study the change of ecosystems over time, we need to understand the rules that govern species distributions. Due to climate change and human disturbance, now more than ever, it is crucial to study the ecological roles of sharks and understand the roles that they play in maintaining ecosystem stability. In order to tackle this task, the Hussey Lab has created a global predator stomach content database, including stomach content data on all studies published to date of stomach content of sharks. So far, we have found over 200 studies and input the stomach data of over 50 from all over the planet and at all latitudes. The stomach content data in the papers provides the specific prey items consumed by the shark, and in conjunction with the location of the study, we are able to determine the niche breath of the sharks. We can then see if MacArthur's hypothesis holds true for the marine environment.